Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Thanks for coming into our house today and checking out what we've got on show. We've got a nice little video today to help you with your organization and customization itch that you might have there in Unraid. I'm going to show you Docker folders, which I think is a pretty cool app, and it really helps you organize your Docker and your VM tabs and applications into nice folders and icons, which just makes it really easy to look at and manage. There's a lot of useful tools in there, which I think you guys are going to absolutely love. Before we get started, just want to quickly let you know that if you want to help support the channel, always remember to subscribe, of course, but you can also become a member on our website, ibracorp.io. You can choose to set up a free plan if you like, there's no cost involved, or you can help support us with some paid plans that will, of course, help us financially to keep the channel going. It's completely up to you. Any help you decide to give is always appreciated. We also have our Discord as well. I highly recommend you guys join the Discord because we are really pushing to help build a community here that involves both developers and the community members of Unraid and help answer your questions that you might have or any issues you might be experiencing. We'd really love to have you. So feel free to join up, spread the link around if you like. You'll find the link in the description and we can't wait to see you. So with all that jibber jabber out of the way, let's just get stuck into the video. Does your server look like this? Do you have an endless list of apps and Docker containers that just seem to go on forever? Well, we have the perfect solution for you. Here's what all those pesky apps could look like if you want using the Docker Folders plugin. It's a fantastic plugin and it really helps organize your setup to make it look so much nicer. Gone away with the huge list of Docker containers, we now have a nice organized folder application. Keeps everything together and it lets you customize it the way you like with your own icons, including animated ones, which I'll show you today. We also have some other features like we can easily access the logs with one click of a button. We can also open the web UI with one click of a button. Now, doesn't that look much nicer? I think so. For all of you out there that like to follow a written guide, we're also starting to write these up into a written format to go with our videos. And I'll have the link down in the description down below. At the moment, it's set to private while we work on it, but obviously by the time we get this video out, we'll publish that out to you as well. And that lets you follow along everything we're doing in the video in a nice text format. So github.com/IBRACORP. That's where you can find our documentation for any of our future videos as well. So now we'll get started. We're in our test server, Pumba. And if we just go over to our Docker tab, we'll have a look here. Obviously on my test server, I don't have as many Docker containers as I did on my main server, which I showed you then at the start. But you can imagine someone might have a fair few Docker containers. Maybe they only have a few. Doesn't matter really, because you can organize it at any point in time. The first thing we're going to do is head over to our community application store. So in the apps here up the top, we'll head over there. What a wonderful store this is too. And we're just going to search for Docker folder. There it is there, we'll click on that. And the one we're looking for is Guildard's repository. Click to install and click done. Now you'll notice if you try to click the settings icon here, it's going to give you a little window saying, hey, you're getting to this the wrong way. Don't stress. All this is saying is, basically, to use this plugin, we just go via the Docker tab or the VM tab. So I'll show you that. Let's head over to the Docker tab. In the Docker tab, you'll notice that down the very bottom, we have Add Folder. Go ahead and click Add Folder. As you can see, here's our interface. Looks pretty straightforward. But what we're actually going to do is flick the top right toggle here to Advanced View. That gives us a couple more options that we can pick from. And then we'll start giving it a name. So for the first one, I'll call it Internet services, for example. Then allows us to upload an icon. So if you have one on your computer that you would like to use, just click this button here and pick it from your computer. But if you want to use our animated icons that you saw in the preview there, what we're actually going to do is go to the GitHub for Hernandito, who has done some amazing work creating some animated icons for the community to use. So big credit there to Hernandito. I'll make sure I bring up the GitHub link now. Just give me 1 second. So here's the GitHub repository here for Hernandito. And if we just have a look through, you can see he's created several different color schemes for each of the animated icons. So it's really up to you what your personal preference is here and what you'd like to use for your system. For the purpose of the video today on the test server, I'll go with the gray collection. Once you're happy with the color that you want to go with, scroll up to the top again. You see here they're named by their color. So let's say gray collection. In there, you've then got a whole list of all the different icons. So let's say for internet services, I want to use the globe icon. Let's go ahead and click that. Now that we're on this page, we can now right click it and copy the image address. Now, depending on your browser, you might see a different option like copy image URL or whatever the case might be. Whatever's relevant for you, we just want the address for that image. So we'll copy that, and then back in our Docker folder here, paste that link into the icon field, and you'll see that it populates the icon now. For the container slash VM preview, we'll drop down the list and click on icon label. Most of these we won't need to change. What we will change though is preview advanced context menu, we'll check that. Activation mode, we'll just leave it as click, and for graph, we'll select combined. I should note that a lot of this stuff is going to be personal preference. I'm showing you the settings for what I showed in my preview so that I can show you how to get exactly what I showed you. But at the end of the day, you can come in, play around with it and see what works for you. Maybe you like a couple of settings to be a little different, each to their own. We'll also check the status icon auto start option here, and I'll show you why once we're done. Now, if your server is not very strong or you just prefer the option, you might want to check only animate icon on hover. I'm going to leave that off because I like seeing the animations regardless. And we'll scroll down a little further and we'll basically get to pick our options here. So under internet services, I've got, you know, I haven't got many Docker containers on here really, but I'm just going to say Nginx Proxy Manager, and I'll put Cloudflare D in there as well. Go ahead and click submit, and there you go. So now we've got our Docker folder, and we can see the containers are now under that folder. So they've moved from this long list into the folder itself. So now that we're in here, we'll start them up. So if I just left click the icon, you can see it gives us this nice little interface. It also gives us a graph with all the statistics and any sort of other information we might need. We'll also have our Docker command, so we can go ahead and start that. And you'll notice now that it's started, we also have an option to open the web UI with one button click. I'll do the same for Cloudflare D, although this probably won't work, but we'll start it up anyway. Now I'll also show you what the auto start option was in the Docker folder settings. So if you were to left click this, you can see we've got auto start set to off. If I was to set auto start to on and then stop this container, I've refreshed the page and now you can see we get this orange icon. So what the orange icon is saying that, hey, you've got a Docker container that is meant to auto start but is currently off. It probably needs some attention. But if I was to click it and say, we don't really want it to auto start, it's something I only start manually, and then I refresh the page again, it's going to give us a green icon, and that's because it doesn't see it as any issue. Everything's working as it should. If auto start is off, then it shouldn't really expect the container to be on. So that's just a nice way to have a quick glance and see if there's any issues as you're checking your server for any containers that are stopped. So I'll flick that back to auto start, and then we'll start the container again. And that's pretty much those two done. Now, if I left click it again, and we just have a look at the graphs here, we'll be able to get an observation on what's happening. It's a really nice graph system. I really like it. Also have all of our easy to access links. So if you wanted to get to the project page, the support page, all of that is in here instead of having to go into the template and open up links yourself, which is pretty handy. You also have the option to auto start an entire folder. So if the whole folder, we didn't want it to auto start, we could just left click this. As you can see, I've refreshed the page. Now both of them have been set to off for auto start. If I flick it again, just refresh, and you can see they've both been marked for auto start again. One extra note I will add though, is if you were to create a new one, so let's go ahead and add folder here. I'll just call this one Media Services. I've then added this icon for it, making sure we're still on advanced view. Set the container preview to icon label. We want status icon auto start. We also want to check the preview advanced context menu again. We'll set the graph mode to combined, and the rest is fine. Let's say here you've gone to add your apps to the folder. So I might add this one, for example. I might add this one. You know, I might add this one. Obviously, this is a database one, so I would probably make that a separate one. But I just wanted to show you the example of, okay, I've made a new folder called Media, and for some reason I've decided, you know what? Nginx Proxy Manager actually fits better in this folder. So what I'll do is it lets you check it. As you can see, it's sort of darkened out a little bit to say that it's already in a folder. But if I was to check it here and click submit, it will move it from the existing folder that it was in to the new one we've just created. So also worth noting that it can only exist in one folder at a time. There are also no subfolders. So it's best to try and organize these folders in a way that makes sense to you without having them too long. I found that going across the screen, it will fit 8 containers, at least on my screen. They may be different on other people's screens, but on my screen, it will fit 8 across. You won't see any more past 8 in this little preview. In order to see the whole list, you can also actually drop the folder down like this. So clicking on the actual folder, that will bring down each individual container that's in that folder. So with that shown now, I'll just show you what a full setup looks like, which I posted in the screenshot to our community tab. So this is what a full list might look like for you. This might be something that matches your setup right now with the amount of containers you might have. So this is pretty much how it would look once you've set it up. Again, you can refine it any way you like, but you have all the logs that you need. You have all the information that you need. You know, how easy is if I just click that, I can see how much resources are being used in the glimpse and all the information I need is there as well. The added feature is that it also works for VMs. If we head over to VMs here, you have the same option. So you can add a folder and then create a folder for your VMs. So as you can see, for my folder for VMs here, I've got authentication services because I'm running a free IPA server. We'll go ahead and edit the folder real quick. And there's a couple of different options here. I don't seem to have the graph option, for example. I might be missing that. And if I do, let me know in the comments. And then if we head to your dashboard, you can actually see your dashboard has the folders, which is awesome. So you can see all your folders from your dashboard pretty much without having to actually even go to the Docker containers. Now, as you can see, I can tell straight away here under authentication services, I've got an orange light. So something's not right there. If I head over to my Docker tab and under authentication services, I can see Authelia is stopped. If I left click it, I can see that auto start is checked. So that tells me that typically this is normally up, but unfortunately something's happened and it's down. So with a quick click here, I can just have a quick brief look at the logs and that'll tell me what's going on. So that's Docker folders, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. So that's pretty much Docker folders, guys. I hope you enjoyed that. It's a nice brief one and something that I think really helps organize your server. Don't forget to check out our Discord. We'd love to have you in there. It's a very welcoming space and we welcome all members from beginners right to advanced, where we can help you with questions or you can bring your own ideas too. We have channels in there for you to request videos you might like to see or any other suggestions you might have. Also our website, ibracorp.io, as well as our GitHub, where we'll post documentation for our work at github.com/ibracorp. Thank you for coming in. We really appreciate you and we'll see you in the next IBRACORP video.